I'm from Alberni Pacific Rim.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. My constituent Susan's two adult sons have developmental disabilities. They rely on the bus pass to get to day programs, to recreational activities, to have some level of independence. Susan wrote to the Minister of Social Development about the challenges her sons face. Instead of listening, the minister replied by saying she, quote, apologizes for any confusion Susan may have experienced due to the misinformation being circulated. Honourable Speaker, Susan is not confused. She has the information. After years of stagnant disability rates, she knows her sons need every nickel for food, for utilities, for clothing. Does the Minister of Social Development think that this kind of patronizing response to people whose families are struggling to get by on disability assistance is the right approach?
Minister of Social Development and Social Innovation.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. The $170 million investment we have made to increase the rates for people with disabilities across this province creates fairness and equity. I understand that people across this province would like to have seen a bigger increase, and that is something we will continue to build on, something we will continue to invest on top of all the other changes and policy reforms we have made in this ministry over the last number of years, on top of the gifting in assets, on top of the annualized earning exemptions, on top of the single parent employment initiative, all ways that we are working towards finding ways for people with disabilities to reach their full potential, to gain their independence, and to be able to be part of community. Thank you.
Alberni Pacific Rim on a supplemental.
I have one, Honourable Speaker. My constituent wrote the minister in response, and she said, your response goes to prove how out of touch your government is with the developmentally disabled community. She goes on, Honourable Speaker, people with disabilities across the province are united in the need for a rate increase, not divided by the difference in transportation subsidies. Further, she states, just do the right thing and raise the rates and leave the bus pass alone. Your government should be ashamed. Will the Minister of Social Development do the right thing, Honourable Speaker? Will she end the bus pass clawback?
Minister for Social Development and Social Innovation.
Madam Speaker, we did in fact do just that. We increased the rates with a $170 million investment. Constituent that the member opposite speaks of still has the bus pass. They will see a $25 rate increase each and every month to ensure that they have more money in their pocket today than they did yesterday. Madam Speaker, I can attest to the fact that I do apologize that there has been misinformation out there. In fact, Madam Speaker, on Twitter on Friday, the National Anti-Poverty Advocacy Group, BC Acorn, has called the NDP rhetoric fake outrage. They agree that the bus pass program the bus pass program isn't the place to focus on, but they have exposed the NDP tactics by saying that it is working in their benefit to help raise the interest in the fact that they want the rates increased. It's not the bus pass, Madam Speaker, it's the rates, and it is something we will continue to work on.